It's hard to keep a smile on your face when you call low on a king and turn over an ace on Card Shark. And now, here's the host of Card Shark, Jim Perry.
Thank you, Jan.
Hello there. Welcome to Card Shark.
Nice to have you with us. Nice to have you with us at home. Thank you. Very kind. And for the opening poem, we'd like to thank Mrs. Casey Schieser of Topeka, Kansas, watching on WDAF-TV Channel 4. Thank you, Mrs. Schieser. Now let's open the board. Get to the cards. Go ahead. And Janice and Chris will load them in. Here come our card sharks. Linda Decker.
Hello, Linda.
Good to see you again. And again, Linda.
Okay, I'm from Kokomo, Indiana. I'm the mother of three boys. I was a former flight attendant for a major airline. I now teach part-time at Indiana Vocational Technical College, and I love to play tennis.
Now, I've got to ask you, are you a gambler by nature?
No, not really. I would say by nature, I think I probably am, but usually for pennies and stuff like that.
The reason I was asking, if you were not with us on our last show, with a lot of cards near the middle, one crack at the money card, she was a very gutsy gambler, $7,200 in cash, and the cards were not that terrific. Your play was. We're meeting our challenger for the first time, Lisa Hartwood. Hello, Lisa. Nice
Hi.
To meet you.
Thank you.
And won't you tell us about you?
Yes, my name is Lisa Hartwood. I live in Glendale, California. I'm originally from Boston, Massachusetts. And I do pay stub and layout at a newspaper here in Los Angeles. And I'm also a freelance interpreter for the deaf. And I'd like to say hello to all of my friends.
Well, that's very nice. That is very nice. Thanks to have you here with us, Lisa.
Thank you.
Is it very hard to learn to speak the
I think you have to have an aptitude for it to begin with. I think a lot of people have a lot of trouble picking it up, but if you're around deaf people a lot, you'll get it just like that.
It's nice, because the more people you can communicate with, the better off we all are. Nice to have you here with us, Lisa. You
Thank
got the cards?
You. Yes, it is.
Then here we go. We start the best two games out of three with a question to Linda, the champion. Linda, we asked 100 psychiatrists. Are most men envious of a woman's ability to give birth? How many psychiatrists think men are envious of a woman's ability to give birth?
I really think that most men are kind of glad they don't have to go through that pain and suffering. So I'm going to have to say the figure's going to be fairly low. I'm going to go with 12.
12 out of 100 psychiatrists said men are envious,
okay,
higher or lower.
Well, I agree with her. I think she gave a good answer, but I think in the field of psychiatry you meet a lot of weirdos. I think it's going to be a little higher than that.
Higher than that?
Yeah.
If it is higher, you'll play your cards. If not, Linda, with three children speaking from experience, you'll play yours. Hit the answer on the head, a $500 bonus. The actual number of psychiatrists who think men are envious of a woman's ability to give birth is 30.
Woo!
30. It is higher. Lisa. Lisa, that means by winning that question, you can start off the match.
All right, we're going to go higher.
Higher than a 2. A 3.
Yeah, higher again.
Whisking it higher.
A 9. Oh, I'm going to freeze that.
She's going to freeze, crunching the cards up as we go there. Goodbye. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. We'll move over the freeze bar, protecting that. What do you do? Forget it. It's dead. You killed it. See, now it's your fault. Lisa needs two cards for the first game of the match. And the question to Lisa. Lisa, we found 100 married men who are top business executives. And we asked them, in your climb up the ladder of success, have you had to put your career ahead of your family? How many successful business executives admitted they have put their career ahead of their family?
Oh, I think that's going to be a really high number. I feel that really career in this country is one of the most important things. I'm going to say a high number, around 67.
67 out of 100 feel they've had to put the career ahead.
I think it's going to be lower than that. I don't think there are that many.
So you say lower.
Yeah, lower.
The actual number of business executives who have put their career ahead of their family is 48. It is lower. But interesting, almost half of them felt that they have. And now let's see what Linda starts off with. A jack.
I like that card. I'm going to keep it, and I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a jack. A 2.
Oh, I love that card. I'm going to keep it, and I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 2. A 3.
Oh, I like that card. I'm going to keep it and go higher.
Higher than a 3. A 4.
Oh, I like that card. I'm going to keep it and go higher.
And if she does have this, would she use the same wording all the way along? She wasn't going to break her luck.
No way.
If she's got this, she has the game and a $500 bonus. She does. 2, 3. She likes that card, and she's going to keep it and go higher. I like giving away the money, and I'm going to keep doing it while we take time out for this commercial break.